Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshit Dwivedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be talking to you regarding the major lakes of the world. This is actually part one of the video. There will be one more part coming after it. So what's the difference between these two parts? So in part one of the video, friends, I will be covering with you some of the, you know, biggest lake, largest lake, highest lake, clearest lake, deepest lake. And in addition to that, I will be covering with you the lakes of North America. Okay. Then I will be covering the lakes of Australia, the lakes of Africa. So all of these lakes will be covering with you, friends. In the part two, friends, I will be covering you with you the lakes of Antarctica, the lakes of Asia, okay, friends, the lakes of South America. So those lakes I will be covering with you in the part two video. So the complete lakes of the world have been covered by me in two parts, friends. Also, one more disclaimer that the lakes of India I have covered in a completely separate video, which is already uploaded on my channel. So the link I will give in the description box below. So kindly watch that link. And also the link of the second part, that is major lakes of the world part 2, will be also given in the description box below. So you can also check it. In addition, you can also go to my geography playlist and environment and ecology playlist and also other subjects playlist in order to watch more videos. So this is presented by me, Harshit Dwivedi, friends. If you want to follow me, the link of my Insta profile is given in the description box below. Also, this video is in English, friends. If you want to watch the Hindi version of the video, the link of that is also given in the description box below. So here is some idea of the lakes distributed in all over the world. This is Great Bear Lake in North America, in Canada, Great Slave Lake in North America, then Great Lakes, Michigan, Superior, Huron, Erie, Ontario. I'm going to talk about it. Nicaragua, then Lake Maracaibo in Venezuela, Lake Titicaca at the border of Peru and Bolivia, Lake Ladoga, Lake Geneva, Caspian Sea, Aral Sea, Dead Sea, in which countries all of these are coming, I will be discussing with you in detail. Don't worry about it. Then Lake Chad, Victoria, Tanganyika, Malawi in Africa. Then Lake Baikal in Russia. It is a straight lake rather than being a round lake. The Qinghai Lake in China, Tawny Sap in Cambodia, Lake Toba in Indonesia, Lake Eyre in Australia. So all of these lakes I will be talking to you, friends. Some most important lakes of the world I will be covering, which are completely enough from the perspective of your exams and your general understanding also. So you will actually be in a position to, you know, attempt these type of questions if something related to lakes is coming in front of you. Okay, friends. So first of all, we will start with that we are going to explore the category of lakes. There are four different categories, friends. First is the largest lake of the world. Second, the deepest lake of the world. Third, clearest lake of the world. Fourth, the highest lake of the world. So first of all, we are going to see the lakes in these four categories, and then we will go on to, you can distinguishing the lakes, you know, continent wise. The very first thing, okay, that if we talk about the largest lakes of the world, see, all the lakes are not round. It's not important that, it's not necessary that their diameter is big, their width is big. Some straits can be straight, some lakes can be straight also, friends. So basically, if you are going to calculate the ranking of a particular lake, it is going to be according to area of the water in that lake and not according to the width or diameter of that particular lake. So the very first lake that comes to our mind is the Caspian Sea. Actually, its name is a sea and it is regarded as the largest lake of the world. Its total area is 1,43,000 square miles. It is quite huge, friends. You can see by the area. Okay. And it is not a completely continental crest. It belongs in the oceanic basin. So because it belongs in an oceanic basin, it is also considered to be an oceanic lake. Now, if you are going to talk about that, what countries are bordering this Caspian Sea? So they are Kazakhstan, Russia, Iran, Azerbaijan, Turkmenistan. Don't worry at all. I am going to show all of these countries to you in the picture. In the next slide here, you can see that this is basically in between the Caspian Sea and it is completely surrounded by land. This is basically a satellite imagery, which will give you a complete idea about this Caspian Sea. So here is the figure, friends. This is Caspian Sea. Let's see by what countries it is surrounded. This is Russia, friends. Here it is Kazakhstan. Then below, Turkmenistan. Here is Iran. And here is Azerbaijan. The capital city of Azerbaijan, this is Baku. Baku is at the Caspian Sea, the bank of Caspian Sea. Baku is a very, very beautiful city, friends. Moving forward. So this was about Caspian Sea. Moving forward to Lake Superior. Now, what is this Lake Superior? It is one of the Great Lakes, friends. Lake Superior's area measures at around 31,820 square miles. Okay, so it is quite a huge lake and it is bounded by two countries. One is Canada and second is United States of America. Okay, and Lake Superior the Great Lakes of USA and North America. Actually, it is at the border of USA and Canada, so we should not say only USA. So Great Lakes, you can say Great Lakes of North America. So this is one of those lakes, Lake Superior. However, it is said that hydrologically and geologically, there are only four lakes. For example, this Huron and Michigan are actually geologically the same lake. But yes, we consider them as two different lakes. So we will say that there are five lakes in this Great Lakes. Okay. So biggest is the Lake Superior. It is fed over by 200 rivers, and some amount of its water drains into Lake Huron because it is connected to Lake Huron. Obviously, all of these lakes are connected to each other, friends, because they form an excellent system of internal waterway in North America. For example, for taking the cargo away to the Atlantic Ocean, these lakes are a big medium. So they are connected by canals to each other. There are several islands in this Lake Superior. So Lake Superior is quite big, friends. This is a scene of Lake Superior. It was taken in December 2004 from Duluth, Minnesota. Next is Lake Huron. We are going to talk about Lake Huron. Lake Huron in the Great Lakes is the second largest lake, and it is the fourth largest lake in the world. These are freshwater lakes. Its area is 23,000 square miles. All these Great Lakes are freshwater lakes. Keep that in mind. So it has an area of 23,000 square miles, friends, and it also contains the world's largest lake island, also known as Manitoulin Islands. We are all going to see it in the figure. Don't worry about it. Also, Lake Huron, like all other Great Lakes, has been formed after the ice age finished and the glacier begins to melt, retreat. So obviously, those water converted themselves into the Great Lakes. This is the shoreline of Lake Huron. It looks quite beautiful, friends. Then, a slight idea about these Great Lakes. These Great Lakes are also known as Laurentian Great Lakes or the Great Lakes of North America. They are actually interconnected freshwater lakes. Okay, Lake Huron, Lake Superior is interconnected. Then Lake Huron is interconnected with Lake Michigan, and the rest of the lakes are connected by canals. So they are present in Canada, United States. Okay, and the Lake Ontario. From there, the St. Lawrence Rivers originate, and this St. Lawrence Rivers meets the Atlantic Ocean. So this St. Lawrence River connects Atlantic Ocean to all of these Great Lakes of North America. So they are Lake Superior, Michigan, Huron, Erie, and Ontario. Hydrologically, as I've already told you, there are four lakes, because Michigan and Huron are hydrologically considered to be a single lake, not two different lakes. So this Great Lakes are the largest group of freshwater lakes on Earth by total area, and they are second largest by total volume. So they are second largest by total volume. That if you are going to consider the complete freshwater resources of the surface by volume, 20% of that water is present in these Great Lakes of North America. Their total surface area is 94,250 square miles. These are the lake, friends. You can see Huron Lake, Superior Lake, Michigan, Erie, Ontario. In this Huron, there is the Manitoulin Islands. Okay, so this is also a very famous tourist spot, friends. Then you can see this Superior Lake is connected to this Lake Huron from here. So excess water of Superior drains into this Lake Huron, because around 200 rivers are draining inside Lake Superior. So obviously, where will the excess water go? The excess water flows to the Lake Huron. You can see this Lake Huron is connected to Lake Michigan by a bigger inlet here. So because of this bigger inlet, it is being said that hydrologically Lake Michigan, Lake Huron are the same lakes, but actually they are considered to be two different lakes. All of these lakes are connected by waterways to each other, and this Lake Ontario from is this St. Lawrence Rivers originate, and this St. Lawrence River goes directly to Atlantic Ocean. So for example, if there is a cargo which is to be loaded from here or here, it will be loaded into Lake Superior, then this Lake Superior will go to Huron, and then from this route, it will go to St. Lawrence River, and then it can go to Atlantic Ocean and any other country. So this inland waterway system is being powered by these Great Lakes in the North American region. Then coming on to our next lake, the Lake Victoria, friends. This Lake Victoria is a part of African Great Lakes. It was named after Queen Victoria by the explorer John Speke. It has an area of 26,600 square miles, friends. It is also known as the largest tropical lake in the world, surrounded by Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania. It is 276 feet deep. Don't worry, I'm going to talk about the map location of this thing. This is a satellite imagery of Lake Victoria. This in between this is a lake and surrounded by land. Moving forward, this is the map of Lake Victoria. Let's see the boundary. So this much part of Lake Victoria is in Uganda, this much part of Lake Victoria is in Tanzania, and this much part of Lake Victoria is in Kenya. So it is present in three different countries: Uganda, Tanzania, and Kenya. Don't worry, I'm going to talk about the other lakes of Africa also. at this point of time, I'm talking only about the biggest lake. Then I'm coming on to the Lake Baikal, which is basically the deepest lake. It is in a straight length. Its width and diameters are not very high, but it is straight in shape. The biggest thing about Lake Baikal is, friends, and obviously it is growing in a rift zone, so you will see that Lake Baikal is not round. Lake Baikal is straight, and the reason for it straight is because it is located in an active rift zone. Coming on to that, it is located in the South Russia, this Lake Baikal, and it is supposed to be 5,314 feet deep. And when you compare the depth of Lake Baikal with respect to sea level, so it is 4,215 feet below the sea level. So many times people think that how can a lake, a continental lake, be so deep? So the reason for that is that it is consisted, it is present in an active continental rift zone, and it is being said that this rift zone is moving apart from each other at the rate of 1 inch every year. And because of this, with every passing year, this lake is getting deeper and deeper. And here you can see, as it is in a rift zone, this is actually straight in shape and this is not round. One reason for it being straight is it is located in a rift zone. Then coming on to our next thing, the clearest lake of the world, it is Blue Lake, friends. This Blue Lake body is also known as Rotomarewenau. It is situated in New Zealand's Nelson Lakes National Park, and there was a research which was carried out by National Institute of Water and Atmospheric Research. This National Institute of Water and Atmospheric Research termed Blue Lake as the cleanest natural body of water known to man today. It is located in New Zealand. Kindly keep this in mind, friends, that this Blue Lake is also, there is Blue Lake in Australia also, North America also, and many other continents also. But the cleanest Blue Lake is present in the country of New Zealand. Lad, keep that in mind. This is a view of Blue Lake. You can see it is very, very beautiful. People go for boating in this lake and a lot of other adventure activities. Then next is the highest lake, friends, highest lake of the world, that is Ojos. So this Ojos is the highest body of water. It is located in Argentina. It is located at a place named Nevada Ojos del Salado in Argentina. Altitude is 6,390 meters above sea level, and 6,390 meters above sea level is quite a height, friends. Okay, it is a small crater lake. Its diameter is only 100 meters and depth is only 10 meters. It is located on a volcano known as Ojos del Salado, also known as the Eyes of Salty Water. This volcano is highest on the earth and it is not completely dormant. That is, it is slightly active. This is the scene of that place from El Muerto. Now, these lakes I've talked about, Lake Superior and the Great Lakes, then Ojos del Salado in Argentina, Blue Lake in New Zealand, Lake Victoria in Africa, Caspian Sea here, and Baikal Lake in Russia. All of these things I've talked about, friends. Then we are going to talk about the lakes of Africa. Don't worry, I'm going to show the map locations of all of these lakes, so you don't need to worry about it. Just I'm going to read here. So Lake Victoria is present in Kenya, Uganda, and Tanzania. Lake Malawi, also known as Lake Nyasa in Malawi, Mozambique, Tanzania. Lake Retba in Senegal. Lake Tanganyika in Burundi, Democratic Republic of Congo, Tanzania, and Zambia. Lake Kariba in Zimbabwe and Zambia. Lake Kivu in Rwanda, Democratic Republic of Congo. Lake Chad in Chad, Cameroon, Niger, and Nigeria. Lake Turkana in Kenya and Ethiopia. Lake Edward in Democratic Republic of Congo and Uganda. Albert Lake in Uganda and Democratic Republic of Congo. Lake Rukwa in Tanzania. Now, the thing will become clear to you when we are going to see at this lake. See here. Lake Turkana, you can see, it is slightly in Ethiopia and Kenya. Then, Lake Kyoga is completely inside Uganda. Lake Victoria, I have already talked to you, so I am not going to talk again about Lake Victoria. Then, Lake Egbert, this Lake Egbert, friends, it is located in Uganda and Democratic Republic of Congo. It is at the border of DR Congo, that is Democratic Republic of Congo and Uganda. Then here is Lake Edward. Lake Edward is also at the border of Democratic Republic of Congo and Uganda. Then this is Lake Kivu. Lake Kivu is at the border of Rwanda and Democratic Republic of Congo. Then coming downwards, friends, you can see here, this is Lake Tanganyika. It is quite straightforward. And basically, this is also in a straight shape because this region is an active continental rift zone. This Eastern African region is an active continental rift zone, friends. So this is also a rift zone. That is why you will see that the lakes here are not very big in width or diameter. They are actually straight because of this, and they're also quite deep also. So Lake Tanganyika, it is at the border of Burundi, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Tanzania, and this country is Zambia. You can see below, this country is Zambia. Then you will see this Lake Rukwa. It is completely inside Tanzania. Lake Mweru. It is at the border of Zambia and Democratic Republic of Congo. I'm just showing you on the map. Then Lake Malawi is here. So Lake Malawi is in Malawi. Then Mozambique, and this is above Tanzania. So obviously Lake Malawi is also known as Lake Nyasa. Nyasa is the name of this lake in Mozambique, and Malawi is the name of this lake in Malawi country. Okay, so this is the idea of the lakes, friends. Then here is the Chad Lake. This is in between the Chad Lake. This red line shows the Chad Lake basin at one point of time, how the basin has contracted a lot. Now this Chad Lake is surrounded by Chad, Niger, Nigeria and Cameroon countries. Okay, then coming forward, friends, these are the last thing that we are going to talk about. These are the lakes of Australia. Okay, so this is Lake Eyre, South Australia. This is around 9,500 square miles, not kilometers. In the last video, in the Hindi one, I think I said kilometers. Just confirm it. I'm not going to tell you the area. So this is Lake Eyre, then Lake Torrens, then Lake Carnegie, Lake Mackay, Lake Frome, Lake Barley, Lake McLeod, Lake Amadeus. But I will say, friends, that these lakes, actually remembering their lakes and location in Australia is not that important according to me. Because Australian lakes are not, you know, asked very much. But yes, from the perspective of your project or from the perspective of your, you know, primary and secondary studies, this thing can be important. You will get an idea about the map of Australia and the location of maps, lakes and rivers there. So here comes the map, friends. In this map, you can see this is Lake Mackay, Lake Amadeus, Lake Gairdner, Lake Eyre, Lake Frome. Okay, there is one more map that I have presented for you. Here you can see. This is the map, friends. In the western part of Australia, you can see this is Lake McLeod here, then Lake Austin here, then Lake Barley here, then Lake Carnegie here, Lake Rassen here, Lake Disappointment here. Then slightly moving towards north, friends. In the north, you're going to find Lake Mackay here, Lake Gregory here, Lake Argyle here, then Lake Woods here. Okay, moving forward, friends, here you can find in the southern region Lake Eyre north, then Lake Eyre south, Lake Gairdner, Lake Blanche, Lake Frome. So basically these are the lakes, and this slide will also give you an idea about the rivers. You can see this is a Mitchell River, Gilbert River, Darling River, Lachan River, Murray River. However, river is not the topic of this video, so I'm not going to go into the details of the rivers here. That I will be discussing in a separate video. Then coming to the lakes of North America, friends, in addition to the great lakes, that is Erie, Ontario, Huron, Michigan, Superior, there are some more lakes which we need to see. That is Great Bear Lake. So you can see the area, it is very huge. Great Slave Lake, Lake Winnipeg, Lake Nicaragua, Lake Athabasca. Lake Nicaragua location is not seen here. You can search it in Google Maps. The rest of the locations I am going to show you in this map. So have a look in this map, friends. These lakes I have already talked to you. The Great Lakes, you are going to leave them aside. This is Great Bear Lake in Canada. Great Slave Lake in North America. Canada, North. If I am saying Canada, if I am saying USA, it basically means North America. So this Great Slave Lake, Great Bear Lake, they are in Canada. Then Lake Athabasca, Lake Winnipeg. So some of these are slightly in the USA also. So this is basically the location of Great Bear Lake, Slave Lake, Athabasca Lake, Lake Winnipeg. And these are the lakes which are other than the Great Lakes of North America, friends. So I hope this video was helpful for you, friends. I have told you an idea about the location of lakes all around the world. And I have told you about the main continents of, you know, Australia. I have talked to you about African continent. I have talked to you about North American continent. Now, in the next video, I am going to talk to you about the lakes of Europe. I am going to talk to you about lakes of Asia, lakes of South America, lakes of Antarctica. I am not going to talk about the lakes of India, because lakes of India I have covered in a separate video. The link of that I will give in the description box below. So if, friends, you like this video, kindly like it, subscribe to my channel, please share it with your friends, kindly tell your friends to watch this video. If more and more people will watch, it will be a great encouragement for you, friends. So keep studying. Thank you and goodbye.